So I was listening to this pastor preach a few years ago, and he was talking about how he got frustrated with God one day because he was having these huge meetings and not much was happening. He was preaching, there was a lot of people coming, but when he was reading in the Bible about like the miraculous things that God was doing, like supernatural protection and like how he fed Elijah and Daniel in the lion's den and the book of Acts and all the supernatural things that would happen, the jail shaking and breaking open and prisoners being released. And he got frustrated and he's like, this is boring compared to that. And he went before God and he was complaining. And he was like, God, how come I'm not seeing this stuff? And right in the middle of his rant, the Lord kind of checked him and was like, you're not in a lion's den right now. Like, you're in a huge sanctuary with a bunch of well-to-do people. And basically God checked him like, there's not a need for the supernatural in the way that the persecuted body has a need of it. You ever notice when the persecution started, that's when the supernatural stuff started. And when people were kind of lazy in their walk and there wasn't a whole lot going on to persecute God's people, that's when they always turned into idolatry. And I was sitting here and I hadn't fasted in forever, and I was just kind of having this lazy attitude. Like, I see the current events, I see what's going on in the world, and I got this irritated attitude, like, you know what, Lord? I've been through enough. Like, I've done years worth of fasting, I've done all the warfare. Like, let me rest. I just want to watch this makeup tutorial on YouTube, and I don't want to think about anything. And I had this kind of like entitled attitude, like, I've been through enough, God. Like, leave me alone. I don't want to work. I don't want to discipline myself. Like, let me rest. And I realized, like, I will perish if I act that way. If I don't get up and fight, I'm going to perish. And I don't mean fighting in the flesh. I mean fighting supernaturally, getting myself ready for whatever's to come, no matter what it is. I have no idea, you guys. I hear one prophet say one thing, another person say another thing, and then the other prophets, they're like, oops, sorry, I missed it. And I really don't really care, honestly, because what kingdom are we serving? What kingdom are we concerned with? I know that it's very concerning for Christians to feel like they're going to be persecuted or lose their rights. It's not fun. But I don't want anyone to forget that all through the Bible, whenever God's people started being persecuted, he would come for them in a mighty way. Daniel in the lion's den, he wasn't sitting at a Starbucks with his church friends. With no persecution, he was going through it. He was fighting his flesh for God. These people were devoted to God. And when hard times came, they didn't fall away because they had put in the work. And so I was just thinking about that today and just thinking about how with great persecution, like we're all kind of afraid of persecution. We're like, whoa, this country is about to change if so and so gets in office or if this happens. We're really scared for ourselves and our comforts. But we might lose a lot of comforts and we might start to get a taste of what other countries have been through as far as persecution. But like, research persecuted countries, research the miracles that happen. I remember the story about these people in Romania, and they decided they were going to go to this godless city and they were going to go to the town square and they were going to sing hymns for the whole town to hear, and they were going to evangelize that way. So a lot of people from church, they got in their church van and they went to the city and they got all set up and they got ready to sing and they couldn't even get through their first song. It started pouring down rain and they were frustrated. They sought refuge in another believer's house in that city and they were inside, and then they heard a knock at the door and it was like one of the elders of the city. And they're like, what now, God? Like, seriously, we come out here to try to do your work and you can't even keep it from raining on us. And now these people are banging on the door. Like, what the heck? Why did we come here? So they open the door and the town leaders, there's a few of them there at the door, and they're like, who were you singing to? What God were you singing to out there? And they were just kind of like, the Lord Jesus. And they were expecting, I don't know, maybe to be stoned or beat up or kicked out of the town, whatever. And the people go, we want to know your God because we've been praying to our gods for weeks and months and we don't have any rain. Like, we needed rain. And as soon as you guys started singing, your God answered everything we've been praying for. So I just shared that story to share, like, how God moves and works in ways that we can't figure out. And we'll think it's a bad day. You know, like for those of you who are so concerned with Trump, like if this doesn't go through and people are saying he's going to do some kind of takeover, or release some kind of records or whatever. And if that doesn't happen, like, oh God, America's going in the trash heap. But some of you want Biden to win and you're thinking, well, Trump, you know, he says he's a Christian, but he's really not. And those people who follow him are deceived. Whatever. I don't know. Okay. I know Jesus Christ and him crucified. And that's what I'm concerned with. But I just want you to be assured that no matter what happens, that God's going to be there for his people. And our job is to cleanse ourselves. Our job is to get ready and have no place in us where judgment can fall. Because if judgment is coming, which I really believe it is, if this nation is about to be torn apart and Christians are about to be persecuted, we have to get as strong as we can in the Lord. We can't be lazy. We can't just be scrolling, looking at what the prophets are saying or what the news is saying. We have to be scrolling our Bible and being around people who love the Lord and getting intense in prayer and fasting, because this is not the time to get lazy. It's not the time to be scared. It's just a time to be ready. And so I just wanted to say that some of us were getting kind of a militant attitude. Like let's stock up on guns and let's be ready because I'm going to fight for my country. And I just want to warn you to be very careful with that attitude, because David was a warrior. Yes, he even killed lots of people because God sent him into these places and he was supposed to battle, and it was bloody and it was messy. And God's just not, you know, super hippie, peace everybody. Like there's times he turns tables and there's times we have to fight. But I want to warn people who are getting into a spirit of violence or a spirit of revenge and a spirit of hatred, even for fellow humans. Like before David went into battle, he always went before the Lord and he would say, Lord, is this you? Are you sending me? Am I going to have victory in this battle? Is this something you want me to go into? And he would go before the Lord and he would ask. And I want you to be careful, because I don't see anything wrong with maybe, you know, if you're into guns, stocking up on them or whatever, but don't forget to stock up in your spirit. Don't forget to go before the Lord and make sure that you're not getting off on some weird stuff, because it's so easy. Fear can make people very, very ugly and can get us out of our spirit real quick and walking in the flesh. And scripture says we're cursed when we trust in the arm of the flesh. If we trust ourselves or any man or any system or anybody besides Christ, we are going to find ourselves confused, even deceived, when things don't go how we thought they should go. Look at the people in the day of Jesus, when they thought, you know, he had been killed and they thought all their dreams and hopes were crushed. He came back with a vengeance. A beautiful vengeance for his people. He brought power to his people to overcome. And if you want that power to overcome, you have to get up and fight. And I know a lot of us have been through so much heartache, so much tragedy, and we feel like we're damaged. I know I do. But it's not the time to let go now. It's not the time to give up. Those of you struggling with anxiety and fear with what's going on, just cling to God. A lot of the trauma that we've been through has helped prepare us so that we won't be blown away completely, just blown away like chaff when hard times really, really came to this country and this world. Some of you who feel like you're so beat down, some of you who feel like that you've been through so much trauma, maybe you struggle with PTSD, going through anxiety and things like that, you think that you're so far from who you used to be that there's no power left in you. But I want to tell you that God can use everything you've been through. He could turn it around and use it as a source of strength and compassion for people. Because when all hell breaks loose and 1,000 fall one side and 10,000 on the other and you're not hurt, you're going to have to be there to tend to those who have fallen, to tend to those who have given up their hope, to tend to those who are wounded spiritually, maybe physically. I don't know what God has for your life, but we are called to bring healing to others. And we can't do that if we're so focused on the outer things. We have to be in tune with Jesus. What if he wakes you up in the middle of the night and says, get out of the city because it's about to be bombed? Like with persecution, with great persecution comes great protection and love from our Father. He is not an abusive dad. He is not treating us like some unwanted stepkids. Like he loves us. He's adopted us as his own. and he's going to be there for us no matter what happens. I want you to just go through and think of those things in the Bible where he protected his people. They were thrown in a furnace. His people were thrown in a furnace for doing what was right. They didn't fight the guards. They didn't say, let's get our swords and chop the guards into little pieces. You're not putting me in that furnace. They were just like, you know what? Do what you want. But no matter what, we're not bowing down to your gods. And God was there. He acted on their faith. He was pleased with them and he helped them out. And so I just don't want us to get so discouraged. And I don't want us to start trying to figure this out with our mind, because the ways of God are not like our ways. And whatever happens in the coming weeks or months, God did not leave us. And if darkness is coming, then the light inside of us is going to be greater. Whatever we have to face, he's going to give that greater grace for us to be able to get through it, and not just get through it and barely survive, but to rise up and be powerful. Some of you think you're so weak and you have no idea. When the crap hits the fan, the Spirit of God is going to come upon you like never before, and you are going to walk in things that you read about in Scripture and wondered, where is it now? There's a famine of the power of God in the land right now. You know why? Because of the mass sin that we're cloaked in darkness, this country. There's things going on that we have no idea about. So much that grieves God's heart. And there's a famine of the true prophetic. There's a famine of the Rhema word, where it just comes alive when you hear it. You know, in the Bible, there was these disciples when Jesus came back and he was unrecognizable in his flesh. He had resurrected and he was walking with a couple of the disciples. They didn't realize who it was until later. And then one of the disciples told the other one, oh, no wonder why our hearts were burning within us when he spoke. That's how it feels when you get a real word from God. That's how it feels when the preaching is alive, when it's not just people pulling an online sermon off and something I could preach about this week. And, but the messages that are coming forth, that are going to come forth in these greater and harder times, are going to be messages from the valleys, messages from people who have been beat down and almost dead. People who are like the guy in the Good Samaritan story, where he was just beaten and left on the side of the road, and the church people walked over him, the priest walked over him, and who helped him? Someone no one expected. And you're going to rise up and you're going to get well. And you're going to walk in a power and a strength that you didn't even know you had. And those who are prideful and those who have been running ministry on their own strength, these times are going to either cause them to break and repent before God, or they're going to fall away, plain and simple. If there's false gospels in their heart, like prosperity gospels and things where nothing bad should happen to you if you have enough faith, they're going to find themselves really confused if they're sitting in a jail cell because they spoke about Jesus. We have to know that with tough times, Jesus is still there with us. He didn't promise us anything except his Spirit and endurance. He didn't promise us that we would have an easy life. As a matter of fact, he said that it would be hard. So with that said, I just wanted to encourage someone today. You're not done. God's not done. The world, whether or not it's coming to an end, the kingdom of God is inside of you. Stir it up. Seek God. Get close to him. Put those things away that you know that he's been dealing with you about, because you need to pick up those things that he's going to have placed in front of you so that you can be a soldier in these times to come, because we're going to need to be strong no matter the outcome. No matter if you get the favorable outcome that you hope for or not, in the fleshly realm, the kingdom of God will still advance. And God will use those who are hearing him, who have ears to hear. So just keep your ears open. Keep your mind unpolluted. If you are getting stressed out, turn off the news, because half of that stuff lies anyway. And get before God and he will speak to us. He will. God bless you.